jumps up and scares them.
Surely you are not frightened of me. What a handsome bear of specimens you are.
I wish you wouldn't refer to us as some kind of animals. We're intelligent beings.
You're entitled to your opinion, of course. What a wonderful addition you would both make to my collection. How would you like to come with me?
Don, you can't be serious.
You would have everything you want, and a life of ease, all the luxuries.
We're not interested.
Well, there's no rush for a decision. Think about it for a while.
I can give you a final answer right now. No.
Just as you wish. But think about it some more anyway. You wouldn't want to make a wrong decision, would you? Exactly what I said. Think about it, my dear.
He just came right out and asked us to go with him.
What was his reaction when you refused to go?
He wasn't angry. Sort of strange. As if he knew something we didn't. Or maybe he was joking.
Well, if he was, he has a morbid sense of humor.
Seeing you caged like a monkey does have its amusing aspects.
The primate is considered one of the higher forms of life, Dr. Smith. When the keeper wants the insect variety, he'll get in touch with you.
All right, that's enough squabbling out of you two for one day.
I don't think the keeper means us any harm.
Why, because he gave you those flowers?
Oh.
Beware of strangers bearing gifts, I always say.
Oh, Dr. Smith, you always suspect the worst of everyone. Now, if the keeper had really wanted to take Don and Judy, he wouldn't have asked them to go with him.
There are seven of us to contend with, dear lady. We represent a formidable group against just one.
I thought the keeper only collected animals.
Maybe that's what he considers us.
Speak for yourself, Major. However, enough of this. I have a brilliant idea to propose. Just suppose that the Major and Judy accept the keeper's ridiculous offer, but with one stipulation.
And what's that?
That in return, the keeper first takes us all back to Earth.
That's brilliant. That is absolutely brilliant, Smith.
For once, you're correct. All we need to do is to have the keeper allow us to come aboard his spaceship. As I said before, there are seven of us. It would be a simple matter.
No. Absolutely no.
I understand your objections, Mrs. Robinson, but sometimes violence is a necessity.
Well, Dr. Smith, no matter how much I want to get off this planet, I won't resort to violence to do so.
In this situation, the end more than amply justifies the means.
Well, not to me, it doesn't. And unless I'm badly mistaken, not to anyone else at this table.
Now, that concludes the matter.